This is Rick Ricardo. Oh, telegram, just a minute, please.
Ike for president, Ike for president, Ike for president, Ike for president. You like Ike, I like Ike, everybody likes Ike
for president.
Hang out the banner, beat the drum, we'll take Ike to Washington.
We don't want John
or Dean
or Harry,
let's do that big job right. Just get in step with the guy that's left, get in step with Ike. You like Ike, I like Ike, everybody likes Ike
for president.
Hang out the banner, beat the drum, take Ike to Washington.
How was the movie?
I didn't go to the movie.
You didn't go to the movie?
No, sir. I went yesterday when I wasn't supposed to.
Oh, is that so?
Yes, sir. And I won a racing bicycle with a guaranteed leather seat. And I hit it at Larry's. And I was going to make believe like I won it today. But I couldn't. So that's why I'm telling you what happened.
One other thing I probably should tell you. Because if I don't, they'll probably be saying this about me, too. We did get something, a gift. After the election. A man down in Texas heard Pat in the radio mention the fact that our two youngsters would like to have a dog. And believe it or not, the day before we left on this campaign trip, we got a message from the Union Station in Baltimore saying they had a package for us. We went down to get it. You know what it was? It was a little Cocker Spaniel dog in a crate that he'd sent all the way from Texas. Black and white, spotted. And our little girl, Tricia, the six-year-old, named it Checkers. And you know, the kids, like all kids, love the dog. And I just want to say this right now, that regardless of what they say about it, we're going to keep him.
I can tell you that from my observations in each one of the countries we visited, that the great majority of the people, the great majority in all walks of life, are friendly to the United States today.
The motorcade stops for traffic. The mob catches up and attacks the cars with stones and clubs. Mr. and Mrs. Nixon are spat upon and reviled.
When danger threatened him, he never got hurt. He knew just what to do. He's ducked and covered.
Korea, United Nations troops push on in the cautious advance against the communists. An advance whose purpose, General Ridgway states, is not to seize ground, but to wipe out the enemy. The Chinese Red Army, fighting desperately in small isolated stands, prefers to give ground on wider fronts rather than join battle. And it's up to the infantry to clear out the pockets of die-hard communists.
We are living in an era marked by the growth of socialism. To a substantial degree, in one form or another, socialism has spread the shadow of human regimentation over most of the nations of the earth, and the shadow is encroaching upon our own liberty. The socialists among us seek to bring about a gradual change in our system by gradually destroying the principle of the private ownership of property.
If I had my way about it, they'd all be sent back to Russia or some other unpleasant place.
We are shareholders in the greatest enterprise on earth, the United States of America Unlimited. Our strength lies in the character of our people, young in heart, independent in thought and nature.
In recognizing a communist, physical appearance counts for nothing. If he openly declares himself to be a communist, we take his word for it.
Or have you ever been a member of the Communist Party?
It's unfortunate and tragic that I have to teach this committee the basic principles of Americanism.
That's not the question.
The question is, have you ever been a member of the Communist Party?
I'm framing my answer in the only way in which any American citizen can frame his
then
answer
you deny,
to the question
then you,
which invades his, absolutely invades
then
his
you
life.
Deny, to, you refuse to answer that question, is that correct?
I have told you that I will
offer right.
My beliefs, my affiliations, and
excuse
everything
the
else to the American public, and they will know where I stand, as they do from what I have written.
Stand away from the stand.
For Americanism for many years, and I shall
stand away from the stand.
Fight for the Bill of Rights, which you are trying to destroy.
I'll take this man away from the stand.
We must not confuse dissent with disloyalty. We must remember always that accusation is not proof, and that conviction depends upon evidence and due process of law. We will not walk in fear one of another. We will not be driven by fear into an age of unreason if we dig deep in our history and our doctrine and remember that we are not descended from fearful men, not from men who feared to write, to speak, to associate, and to defend causes that were for the moment unpopular. This is no time for men who oppose Senator McCarthy's methods to keep silent.
Senator, may we not drop this? We know he belongs to the Lawyers Guild. And Mr. Cole nods his head at me. I did you, I think, no personal injury, Mr. Cole.
No, sir.
I meant to do you no personal injury.
No?
And if I did, I beg your pardon. Let us not assassinate this lad further, Senator. You've done enough. Have you no sense of decency, sir? At long last, have you left no sense of decency?
I know this hurts you, Mr. Welch.
May
I say, Mr. Chairman, as a point of personal privilege, I'd like to finish this.
Senator, I think it hurts you too, sir.
Every one of you listening to my voice, tell the world, tell this to everybody wherever they are. Watch the skies everywhere.
People of Earth, attention. People of Earth, attention. This is a voice speaking to you from thousands of miles beyond your planet.
They're coming down to take over. They made that clear to us in the saucer.
CBS Television presents a special report on Sputnik 1, the Soviet space satellite. Douglas Edwards reporting.
Until 2 days ago, that sound had never been heard on this Earth. Suddenly, it has become as much a part of 20th century life as the whir of your vacuum cleaner. It's a report from man's farthest frontier, the radio signal transmitted by the Soviet Sputnik, the first man-made satellite as it passed over New York earlier today.
Same kind of thing that's watched us since the beginning of the project.
Family of flying fun. Now, 7 different Frisbees. 7 ways to discover the wonderful world of Frisbee flight. Frisbee, everybody's idea of a good time. Get in on the fun with the Shoop Shoop Hula Hoop. The hoop with the sound. For more tricks, more fun, get the Hoop of Champions. Frisbee and Hula Hoop, sold separately from Wham-O.
Good turnout today, Harry.
Yes, Governor. You'd never guess there'd been any controversy over our new highway, would you?
Well, from the size of this crowd, it appears that most of your people like the idea now.
I'm sure most of them do. But I'll have to admit there are 2 or 3 folks out there I never thought would show up today. Even the head of our business improvement committee and the descendant of our founder are here today. Maybe they've finally seen the light.
Jack, I sure hope your grandfather Connor's not turning over in his grave at what's happening here today.
Well, if he is, Bob, it isn't because you and I didn't fight it all the way. Now that it's built, let's hope we have been wrong. Hello, Ralph. How's the dairy farm? Haven't we convinced you farmers yet?
Nope. But what's done is done. Now if they'll just cut that ribbon, I can get on in the market and see if this road is worth the trouble it's caused me.
Congress responded with the Federal Aid Highway Act of 1956, providing the staggering sum of $51 billion to be spent by the states on highway construction by 1971. The most talked about phase of the act is the interstate highway system, a 41,000-mile network of our most important roads. Most of these roads will be 4, 6, even 8-lane expressways.
My name is Ronald Reagan. Last year, the contributions of 16 million Americans to the Crusade for Freedom made possible the World Freedom Bell, symbol of hope and freedom to the communist-dominated peoples of Eastern Europe, and built this powerful 135,000-watt Radio Free Europe transmitter in Western Germany. This station daily pierces the Iron Curtain with the truth, answering the lies of the Kremlin and bringing a message of hope to millions trapped behind the Iron Curtain.
Hello, Mary Lou. I knew Mary Lou. We never part.
high class. Well, that was just a lie. Yeah, they said you were high class.
Jumping into 10th position this week, Tutti Frutti. And here to sing it in person is the man who made it a hit. One of America's greatest recording stars, Pat Boone.
Jack, I sure hope your grandfather Connor's not turning over in his grave at what's happening here today.
Well, if he is, Bob, it isn't because you and I didn't fight it all the way.
Are you going to go to school here at Central High? Don't care to say anything, is that right?
Jack Kerouac.
I was traveling west one time at the junction of the state line of Colorado, its arid western one, and the state line of poor Utah. I saw in the clouds huge and massed above the fiery golden desert of Evenfall, a great image of God with forefinger pointed straight at me. Through halos and rolls and gold folds that were like the existence of a gleaming spear in his right hand, which saith, come on, boy, go thou across the ground. Go moan for man. Go moan. Go groan. Go groan alone. Go roll your bones alone. Go thou and be little beneath my sight. Go thou and be minute as seed in the pod. Go thou, die hence. And this world report you well and truly.
Tamari is a drag, man. Tamari is a king-size bust.
Radioactivity is dangerous. But to say that it's deadly, period, is as misleading as giving a flat answer to the question, how high is up? The radium-treated dial of your watch, for instance, is harmless. Nuclear emanations became a threat when man isolated such hot stuff as radium and worked intimately with it, broadening its scientific, medical, and industrial use. A threat, however, that has been effectively controlled through observing caution.
And cover.
I saw the best minds of my generation destroyed by madness. Starving, hysterical, naked, dragging themselves through the Negro streets at dawn looking for an angry fix. Angel-headed hipsters burning for the ancient heavenly connection to the starry dynamo and the machinery of night. Who poverty and tatters and hollow-eyed and high sat up smoking in the supernatural darkness of cold water flats, floating across the tops of cities, contemplating jazz.
Major candidates for the presidency.
The candidates need no introduction. The Republican candidate, Vice President Richard M. Nixon, and the Democratic candidate, Senator John F. Kennedy.
The cameras you see before you are color cameras. They are now transmitting a black and white picture. By pressing this button, which I now do, the cameras are transmitting a live color picture.
And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country.
You've had a lot of fun. You've had an opportunity to attack me, and I think I've given as good as I've taken. I leave you gentlemen now, and you will now write it, you will interpret it, that's your right. But as I leave you, I want you to know, just think how much you're going to be missing. You don't have Nixon to kick around anymore.
Grave at what's happening here today.
Well, if he is, Bob, it isn't because you and I didn't fight it all the way.